All right, back again, critiquing my own performance on Firefighter week 2. Apparently some guilds seem to struggle to do this consistently, so I figured why not help you guys out and explaining how we were able to wipe 70 times to this boss, and then the next week wipe 4 times, and then it's done. Same people, not that much of a gear difference, just how our progression went. So, in phase 1, we found that some classes were doing considerably better than others, and it was pretty consistent across several attempts that even though you're melee, you can still do really well and do a lot of damage in this phase. So don't let your guild master or other people bring you down saying that melee is bad on Firefighter, blah blah blah. It's difficult to play, yes, but once you get the rhythm of it, our melee were able to perform really well. As you can tell by the skeletons on the ground, even though we do significantly better this week, it's far from being a guaranteed kill. Phase 1 almost over, pins up on the tank, prevent Argent from proccing. Same as every week. You can tell at this point that this is a pretty good attempt. No one is dead, no combo dresses has to be used. In phase 2, you can see that melee struggle a bit more with the strat that we're doing, because they have to drop flames on the boss to prevent all of us from stacking in one spot, taking way too much shotgun damage, and this makes it so sometimes they need to focus on actually kiting flames rather than hitting the boss, so they can have bad uptime. So you would think that phase 2 melee would actually be able to carry damage, but for us that wasn't the case. Right there, people misplayed the fires quite a bit. I don't know if it was because people didn't stack properly. Let's go back. So we're stacking up. Yeah, you see, there were some people that were too slow to get stacked. And what happened is they dropped their flames on everybody else, and that's why all shields got cleaned and we fell behind on healing instantly. So, dropping first flames here in phase 2. Nothing special. We stack up in our usual spot like we did 70 attempts before. Melee dropping melee fires. Something we found extremely helpful is after you stack up and drop flames, no matter if it's phase 4 or phase 2, is that you have half of the group going left, half of the group going right. So in case one is getting shotgunned, you spread the damage a little bit. Dropping fires close to the existing bomb, but still far away so you can run away if you don't have engineering. That's a bad fire. I'm not sure if that one gets extinguished. It did, so. So yeah, dotting classes, extremely useful. Melee classes, not so much in this phase. But I think this phase is rarely a problem when progressing. We didn't have that many deaths here. No, this was fine, even on the second week. So in phase 3, we have gotten a lot more consistent. There's a lot of stuff going on. And people struggle to learn how close can I get to emergency bots, where do I drop fires, but this week that was all fine. We still struggle with threat on the assault bots. I think this can be helped if you have the DKs using army in this phase. That can ease off some of the pressure of the tank and people dying to assault bots over aggro. Dropping some good flames, don't want to be too close to an emergency bot. The goal now is to bring the head down as fast as we can and make sure we do damage to it. We found it to be extremely helpful. We only run 2 DKs. Many guilds play with way more Death Knights, and what you can do then is that as soon as the bomb bots come down, you AMS grip them and you have a DK just tank them and you make a rotation. We have our DKs communicate that, okay, I can't get this one, I'm icing it, stuff like that. Right there, we lost a person because he was standing too close where the assault bots spawn, and he got killed because of it. Since we're in the midst of a transition, use combat res him. He helps with dotting stuff up. I'm pre-shielding heavily now to try to take some pressure off when the phase starts, because we're kind of stacked at the start of it. So, at the start of this fight, I think a lot of people understand the importance of playing this safe and controlling the fires, dropping them far out. Melee walks out right now, we don't want any fire in the middle of the room, stuff like that. But as you can tell by the damage meters, this is damage done during the heroism, where most people are alive. And melee can still contribute a lot to you making the enrage timer or not. If they play too safe, and they don't min-max their positioning, you will not make the enrage. But if you have people like our warrior, who is able to do even more damage than the warlocks, they can carry the fight. Our warrior is playing Fury here, and we play with combat roll. So right here, you just have to have faith in that people play around the mechanics of the fight. We noticed that the fires are really good on this attempt, so if we manage to keep people alive now, it's pretty much done. Trying to drop as safe fires as we can. As a Disc Priest, you just go back to the basics of every global should be a shield somewhere. You have no priority over anything else. Whoever is in your range is a good assignment. If you look at damage done for the whole of phase 4, you can tell that even some people who died early on or in the middle of the fight, stuff like that, they are still able to contribute quite a lot in total damage because they did so much during the heroism. So even if they die later on, if they were able to really push when it mattered, they can guarantee the kill even if they fuck up a mechanic. So don't focus too much if you have people in your guild dying in phase 4. If they do a lot of damage in total, that's good enough.